second workshop of our semester, day one. This is David Stagg. He's generous enough to come. He's from the Schipul Web Marketing Company. So welcome him.
So I should say, my name is David Stagg. I'm the creative director at this place called Schipul. It's a company of about maybe 25 to 30 people given the day. And we design and build websites for a living, but we also have things like a search engine marketing team, communications team. But for the most part, what we do is we solve problems that clients have that are web-centric. So I'm the creative director there, so every day I look at designs, critique designs, work with the design team on what the clients want to see, that kind of stuff. And I do a lot of building, so I build all the websites, well, not all the websites, but do a lot of the builds that come in. So when we have a design that's approved, somehow it's got to get up there and make it actually function. We all do that. We have a team of people that do that as well, and I manage that team. So that's kind of what I do. If you really, really want to know more about me, you can go to my blog, or you can follow me on Twitter, but I don't recommend either one of these because it's not always appropriate. But it's, if you do want to know me more, you can. And so Elizabeth originally, or I was originally told that I would be speaking to you all about web design in the real world, and it would be something along the lines of informal question and answer session about how I got to where I was at, what kind of degree I needed or don't need, what kind of things you need to do to get a job in the industry that I have, stuff like that. But then she told me that it was going to, yesterday actually, that it was going to be more focused on content management systems. So I was like, well, it's a good thing I do that every day, so I can kind of talk about that as well. But I love to function in an interactive environment, so if you have a question, don't wait till I'm done. Raise your hand and we'll talk it out, because that's how this thing is going to get a lot better. I find a lot of times when working with people, they sit there and have a question, and I somehow haven't fully explained how I got to step three, and they're still back on step one, and they're lost the rest of the time. It doesn't do them any good. So any kind of questions you have about it, just holler out, raise your hand up, and stuff like that. So. How many people here are actually familiar or have worked in WordPress or Drupal before? I know we talked about it a little bit. So for the rest of y'all, this is a fairly green, kind of new idea.
What about Joomla?
Or worked in Joomla. I'm not going to show any Joomla examples, but yeah, if you concept of content management. So for those of you who do know, sit tight for a second, because for those of you who don't, I was going to kind of explain a little bit how we got to where we are today. This is a website. Okay, so I can go into, create an HTML file, put in some code there, the most basic code you possibly need to make a website happen, and then save it, upload it to a server, and you can get this up here, which is outstanding. This was a huge step because it's what makes the internet happen. But I can also do things like save this as about.html, and go in here and say, well, so you want them to click on here, take them to the About page. And we wait. So, Saturday, y'all are here, that's great. I'm really proud of y'all. I was saying to Elizabeth earlier that, that it's funny because I get to do this and go get paid to do it every single day of my life. I do the wrong thing every single day of my life, and that y'all are actually taking your time out of your schedule to come do it and not get paid for it. So, it's very impressive.
So, you came from Austin?
No, I didn't come from Austin. I was born in Philadelphia, but I basically grew up in Houston. Did I say Austin sometimes?
No, I was thinking Schipul was in Austin. Isn't Schipul?
No,
it's in Katy?
I wouldn't go so far as Katy. It's out on the west side. It's at like Derry, Ashford, and Montana. So it's like right there. Okay, so if we do that and we go, we can also create a page like about.html and take this word and link to it. So then we have a new page called about.html, which is great. We can go in and we can change this code. There is a point, don't worry, I'm getting there. Like that. That's good. And so the problem that this presents is if we wanted to change the look of what's on this page compared to what's on the last page, or if we wanted to change the titles across the board, or we want to insert something on all these pages, right now, or as it exists today, is we had to go in and manually do it page by page by page by page. And when I was growing up and trying to learn the internet, this is how we did it. And it was really time consuming, really annoying, nobody loved it. So as time went on, people started developing what they call content management systems that takes all that junk and does it for you on the fly and puts it everywhere else that needs to go. So that's how we ended up with the phrase content management system. So we have a bunch of content, people want to get at it, we want them to get at it, this is good stuff. We need a system to manage that, so hence content management system. So it kind of works like this. This is a database. And for anybody that doesn't understand what a database is, it's literally like kind of like an Excel spreadsheet. You have rows and you have columns and that's it. Data gets put in, and all you do with the content management system is pull it out somehow. So it's really not that complicated. It sounds really techy and kind of scary, but it's really not that bad. So this is my poor impression of a content management system interface. This is my poor impression of a website. So beforehand, we just had this. But then what they invented was, we can go ahead and we can create this guy. We can put some information here, hit save, it goes saves it here, and then it can get called out over here. So when I want to go into this guy and update something, I go and hit save again, it goes, finds that row, okay, we're looking for the title row, because this is the title we want to change. We go in and we save, so it's going to change that to say something else, whatever we put in here, and it's going to spit that title back out right here, based on what I got from here. Parts in your pear tree. Everybody got that? it's really not as complicated as it sounds. It took me forever to learn the concepts of, okay, well, I'm looking at the back end of a website. Is this the database? What's the server? What kind of content am I actually changing here? That kind of stuff. So it helps to kind of have an idea of what's going on here. So occasionally you'll be able to save information on the front end, which is basically what you view. The front end, and if you people that access or interact with the front end, we would call an end user. So an end user comes in and has to submit some information here or something like that. It can talk back to the database and put that in there directly. So we don't need a content management system per se to do that, but we do need some kind of database. You gotta put it somewhere. It doesn't just exist. So it can sometimes talk back this way. That's why these go like this. And obviously this has to spit back to here, and this has to give you information here, because you got to edit it, save it, back and forth. But then whenever you're ready, you hit publish or submit or update, it goes that and puts it back out here. So that's content management. And so now I'm going to show you how it works for real. So we don't ever have to deal with this junk anymore. This would be a nightmare. It would be very painful and cost a lot of money. So I think the things that Drupal and WordPress, which just so happens to be the two things that my company works with all the day, every day. We don't do Joomla. I don't like Joomla. I apologize, people who do use it. I think that you can do anything in Joomla quicker and easier in Drupal. But it's kind of like saying, what's your favorite color? Oh, it's red. Well, why? I don't know. I just really like color red. Okay, well, I like black. It's cool. You know, no harm, no foul. So. Don't hurt me after class. So this is my sister's blog. It's pretty simple content management. It's a pretty simple thing. It's just a blog. It's got a running list of posts. You can categorize things. You can click on the category, and it'll give you, you know, a list of things that she has tagged as pictures and so on and so forth. So I was going to kind of show you the back end of this, so you can see how it comes out this way. So this is the WordPress dashboard. So all I've done is log in, just for the record. I went to the login screen and logged in. That's it. It looks like this. When you log in, it comes to this. So the first thing you'll notice, and this is different about WordPress and Drupal, is that the back end doesn't look like the site itself. So it's pretty important to notice, because there's a bunch of schools of thought and theming and templating. Hey, if we're editing a page, we want it to look like it's on the page already, or do we want to do it like this? And then having to hit save and have to go look at it somewhere else. So just notice that's the first thing you'll notice. So we can do everything we want here. So let's take our most recent post. So if I hit posts, it gives me a running list of all the posts that she has here. And all this page is doing is going into a table in the database. And when I say table, I mean like Excel. It says title here, and then there's a bunch of titles going down the row. And all it's doing is saying, hey, wherever you see that title in this row, I want you to put it right here. I want you to put it right here. And so it just does it over and over and over and over again. So this is our most recent one, Friday Things. And this is obviously the edit post screen. So this is what I'm talking about right here, in this version of the process. So we can go in and we can change the title, we can go in and we can change any of this content down here. You know, we can add stuff like that in there. So this content right here gets stored in the database under the content area. So, it's funny, if you look in the database, it's all one line. So no matter how long this is, it's just like content that goes all the way out until the post is done. And so all it does is take that, and when we hit update like this, all that did was save it from here back down to here. And so this is all live. This is the website, all the stuff, it's on the internet. I can get to this from anywhere. I can't get to the server database from here. I'd have to log in somewhere else where the actual database lies. Can't get there. But all it did was go in and save it here. And the beauty of it is when you go back over here, obviously, in case you haven't figured it out yet, that's going to change what spits out over there. I'm going to delete that before I get in trouble. But here's the scary part. And this is the part where everybody kind of gets, you know, because the number one thing about WordPress, if we have a client who we think is not techie at all, we try to put them on this. It is the most intuitive content management system there is. When you logged in, you could pretty much figure out what to do. It's not too difficult. But what is difficult to do, and the reason that we make money, is because we have to set that up to do all that kind of stuff. So over here, you can see like all the files that we kind of use to power the website. So if we go over here and let's say, let's look at the main index template. All this is for the root level right here, cappuccino.info. So the main index template, that's what this is. So this is where it gets a little more scary.
What did you click on?
Over here on the left, appearance editor. Okay. So if you can install free themes for WordPress. If you go around, just Google WordPress themes, you can spend days just looking at them.
I got Artisteer. You guys use that?
I'm sorry?
Artisteer. Mm-hmm.
What is that?
It's a template generating program for WordPress and Joomla, and I think Drupal.
So you submit something to it and it gives you something back?
No, it's software that's housed on your computer. I actually have it on my laptop. I'll see it later.
Yes.
It's